Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through the introduction of floating point arithmetic operations. Guys, basically, even the operations in complex computers or complex programming will be using floating points. Floating points are nothing but the decimal numbers, guys, like 10.11, like this. This part will be calling as floating point, right? Okay, so high level languages specify floating point and real numbers, guys. So floating point hardware is expensive and more efficient than software. So basically a floating point has two parts, guys. Those are called as mantissa and exponent. Guys, these are all things we have discussed already in the first chapter, guys. We have discussed all the operations on these floating points also. So basically, if there is a question given that the number is 537.25, so slowly you'll be moving this point once, twice, thrice. So 0.57 into 10 to the power of thrice, 10 to the power of 3. So that's how we can write it, guys. Fine? Okay. So this is how we'll be representing a number in terms of mantissa and exponent. So we'll be calling this whole part as mantissa m into 10 power e. E is nothing but our exponent. Fine? Perfect. So you may ask me that how we will be doing the addition or subtraction or multiplication. Okay, so let us try to do addition between these two numbers. So the numbers are 0.537.2400 into 10 square and 0.158 into 158 4 zeros into 10 power minus 1. So the first step that you do is align these powers, guys. Here it is 2, here it is minus 1. So which is greater? Is 2 greater than minus 1 or minus 1 greater than 2? As 2 is greater than minus 1, we will be making both the powers to be 2, guys. Fine? Okay. So to make this power to 2, what we can do? We can just multiply into 10 to the power of 3. Right? Okay. So that's what we have just did it here. So we got this as our result. And further moving on, I think it's wrong, basically. Yeah, guys, it's wrong. If you multiply here with 10, it should move onto that side. So here we'll be considering the lesser thing, guys. So we can consider here that here we need to convert that 2 into minus 2. Fine? Okay. So you will be multiplying here with minus 10 power 3. So this 5 will be moving like this, guys. 0.000537, like that. So just solve it on yourself, guys. You will be adding these 2 and this will be 10 square. So you will be getting a result something like this. It's not the result. Something like that only you will be getting, guys. Fine? So now you will be using the normalization method. Normalization method is nothing but you will be removing the zeros on the right side of the point. You'll be just pushing them that side by decreasing the power here. Fine. So this can be done in 4 different ways, guys. Those are nothing but single magnitude, signed magnitude, signed ones magnitude complement, signed twos complement, and biased exponent. Got it? So suppose we want to convert a number. Suppose the number is 99 to 150. To convert it into some terms of negative, from minus 1 to something or 0 to in particularly negative. Fine? Okay. Just to subtract this part to make it 0, guys. So, minus 50, minus 50. Fine? So, we got here 0, here 49. So, this 49 plus 1 is nothing but 50. So, again subtract 50, 50. So, here you got minus 1 to minus 50. So, this is the negation form of these numbers. So, like that also you can convert, guys. So, now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So, basically there are few register configurations which we will be using here, guys. So, capital letters represent mantissa and small letter represent exponent. AS, BS and QS represent the sign. A is MSB, E is carry. So this is all the representation of all those things, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through addition and subtraction for floating points numbers, guys. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.